Hi everybody, my name is Maxime Chagnot. I'm a culture engineer working for PLM Group in Norway. And today I will show you how we can create a basic assembly in 3DEXPERIENCE using two different parts. Let's see. Okay, so to create an assembly, we can either click on physical product or new content. I can select physical product there as well. And here I can make assembly, block, and axle. Click on OK, and it will create an assembly, but with nothing in it yet. And it automatically opened Catcha Assembly Design because this was the different app I used last time. Okay, so from there, we can either search the part we want. So let's see, I will select block, and click on enter, and there I can open the block I've created today. Click on open, and I will have it in a different window here, a different tab. Assembly is there, the block is there. Before to continue, I just want to put some color. So I select the part body, click on properties, and there it is. Go to graphic and add some color. Maybe like a blue or something. Okay, so then we can see it easily. And what we can do from there is minimize the window here and drag it into this one. So that's just one technique. So this tab now is empty, but this tab here has two different elements. So if we minimize, we can see that we have the block in there and the assembly block in this one. You can drag and drop it in the assembly like that. And that's how you can import a part into an assembly. That's one way. Let's see the second way. So I can close now the window here. I don't need it. And expand this again. And we can close this tab because it's empty. The second way we can do it is going to the assembly here and either right-click insert existing product, or I can go to product modification and do it also from there. I will right-click, insert existing product, and this time I will write it axle, and I select my axle. So the part will arrive here and in the middle of the assembly, and what we can do like we did before, we can just color it. So if you double-click on the 3D shape, you see the white logo here, the blue logo here is the 3D part, this is the 3D shape. If I double-click here, now I switch to Catcha Part Design. And if I double-click on this one, I switch back to Assembly. So if I double-click on the white one here, I am in Part Design, and I can also show you another trick. Go to Display, Object Properties, and we can also color it directly from there. Select my Assembly, and put some color. Let's put this one, and I want to color my part body, and it's done. Okay. So we can now go back to the assembly top level. Here it is. Double click on the assembly, catch assembly design, and now we are going to do two things. First, we are going to fix this part there. So you can click on fix here. I will fix my block. Here it is. I've created an engineering connection called fix. I can update. And now this part here is fixed, so I cannot move it anymore. As you can see here, this is called a robot, and you can drag and drop it in the part like I do so. If I do that, I can now move this axle into this direction or this direction, or even turn it like that. So this is very helpful. And that way I can already place it around how I want it. We are going to make, we can select the element here directly, or we can open the engineering connection panel. And there you can say you want to make maybe a revolute, and selecting axis and plane. So let's do that. I select the axis and the axis. Here it is. And the plane here, and as you can see, we are inside the part, but the blue part become transparent, so we can just select through it, and now we have made Revolut. In that case, we can even put an angle if we want to. If I select this one and this one, this the angle is equivalent to zero. And I can control or I can make it driving. Just keep it that way for the moment. Click on OK, there is no clash, that's good. Now we have made an assembly. And again, update the assembly, everything is good. And now we can save. But before clicking on save, I can show you also the save with option. If I do that, I will have a panel showing me everything that has been creating so far. And everything here is new. So the assembly at least is new. So I can click here and click on OK. I want to save everything. I've updated my block and axle. This is why they are also modified. And now it's done. We have an A here, meaning the assembly has been saved in the platform. So that was it for me today. Thank you very much and have a nice day.